Hi, I'm Jonathan Wild, and we cover how to record adjusting entries for prepaid expenses or deferred expenses. Prepaid expenses are assets that you pay for in advance, but are used up over time. We need to record adjusting entries for prepaid expenses when we use accrual accounting, meaning we record the prepayment of expenses as assets until those assets are used up. For example, if you buy a 6-month insurance policy on December 1st and pay $3,000 cash up front, you have a prepaid expense. To record the prepayment, we debit prepaid insurance for $3,000 and credit cash for $3,000. We debit prepaid insurance to increase that asset account. Prepaid insurance is an asset because of the future benefits of having insurance coverage. Also, see that we don't initially record any expense. This is because we have to spread it out over the 6 months that we have the coverage. So, how do we do that? Well, let's fast forward to December 31st, which is the end of the accounting period for the company. And for the December 31st financial statements to include all expenses incurred using accrual accounting, we need to record an adjusting entry for insurance expense. That is because between December 1st, when the insurance was purchased, and December 31st, when the financial statements are prepared, 1 month of the 6-month insurance policy has expired. And because that happened, we need to record 1 month of insurance expense. To do this, we take the $3,000 cost and multiply it by 1 over 6 months. This gives us insurance expense of $500 for the month. To record this, we debit insurance expense for $500 and credit prepaid insurance for $500. We debit insurance expense to increase expenses. We credit prepaid insurance to reduce that prepaid asset account because now 1 month of that insurance has expired. Let's look at another prepaid expense example, and this time with supplies. So let's say the company started with no supplies and therefore purchased $10,000 of supplies on credit during December. To record the purchase, we debit supplies for $10,000 and credit accounts payable for $10,000. Supplies is an asset because of the future benefits of using the supplies. But we don't actually record any expense until we use the supplies. So let's fast forward to the end of the accounting period, December 31st, when we physically count our supplies on hand. So remember, we started with no supplies and bought $10,000 of supplies during December. Now, on December 31st, we physically count our supplies and see that we only have $8,000 of supplies left. This means we used $2,000 worth of supplies in December. And because we used those supplies, we need to record an adjusting entry on December 31st to recognize that expense. So we record a debit to supplies expense for $2,000 and a credit to supplies for $2,000. We debit supplies expense because debits increase expenses. We credit supplies for $2,000 to reduce that asset account to $8,000. Let's do another example, but this time with plant assets, which are long-term assets like equipment, machinery, and buildings. When companies purchase these assets, they expect them to be used for many years. And to allocate the cost of these assets over many years, we use something called depreciation. So let's do an example. Assume a company purchases equipment for $24,000 cash on December 1st and expects the equipment to have a useful life of 5 years or 60 months. At the end of 5 years, we expect the equipment to be worthless and have a $0 salvage value. To record the purchase of equipment on December 1st, we debit equipment for $24,000 and credit cash for $24,000. Equipment is an asset because we expect future benefits from using it in operations. Next, let's fast forward to the end of the accounting period at December 31st. The equipment has now been used for 1 month, and we need to record an adjusting entry to recognize depreciation expense for the month. We record depreciation because it allocates the cost of equipment over its expected useful life. And to compute depreciation, we take the purchase price, which in our example is $24,000, subtract the estimated salvage value, which in our example is zero, and multiply that by 1 month over 60 months, as we have used the equipment for 1 month of its 60-month useful life. This results in depreciation expense of $400 for the month of December. To record this adjusting entry, we debit depreciation expense for $400 and credit accumulated depreciation on equipment for $400. Accumulated depreciation is a contra account, meaning it reduces the account it is linked to. In this example, accumulated depreciation is linked to equipment, and it reduces the amount reported for equipment. So, when equipment is reported on the balance sheet, we see our original cost of $24,000 less the $400 of accumulated depreciation for a book value of $23,600. Book value is the asset's cost minus its accumulated depreciation. So to wrap it up, we initially record prepaid expenses as assets. As the asset is used up, we record adjusting entries to record an expense.